So the motion for the animal I mimicked was a cranium locomotion. As you can see on my diagram, really just the posterior half of the body moves. What I found was that the flexibility of the caudal fin, which was my main propulsor, decreases vertical force and improves propulsion. So the more flexible that fin is, the better that propulsion will be. That was one of the factors in the failure of my hopper. I also found that the pitching amplitude is between 20 degrees and 40 degrees, which is really that rotational distance here. The formulas I used was for spring constant was Hooke's law, where force is equal to K times the displacement, K being the spring constant. You can rearrange this to have the mass times the acceleration due to gravity divided by the displacement. To find the displacement, I actually just tied a mass to a rubber band. In this case, the mass was 200 grams, and I measured that displacement. With this spring constant, I actually plugged it into my simple harmonic motion formula. This really just gives me the time it takes for one rotation. That was 0.993 seconds, almost 1 second. With this, I found the angular velocity. As you can see, I have the hoppers and the theoretical. The reason for that is the hopper actually has, my actual hopper has an amplitude of 70 degrees, while the theoretical has an amplitude of about 30, which is the maximum efficiency one. For my hopper, it was 1.23 radius per second, and my theoretical, it was 0.527 radius per second.